Okay, salut tout le monde, j'espère que vous allez bien. Okay, so I'm going to do as quick as I can make it, a presentation on chez moi, la maison, vocabulaire de la maison. Okay, so the house vocab. So this is a lot of what you've done already in third year, so you know, it's revision. So chez moi means at my house. Okay, so moi j'habite dans, so me, I live in. Une maison is a house. Une maison. You know this word well, just to remember that it's feminine. Le domicile is another handy word to know. It refers to the house, the home, basically. So, le domicile refers to the home. So, une maison, a house. Un pavillon, a bungalow, double L is silent. An apartment. An appartement meublé is a furnished apartment. Les meubles are furniture. So, meublé, furnished. Un studio is just a flat. It's a really, really small flat. Like an apartment would have a couple of rooms in it. The studio is the flat. Literally, it's one room plus your toilet. Un immeuble, an apartment block or a block of flats. Un chalet is a chalet, a ski lodge. Un gîte is a holiday home. Une maison individuelle is a detached house. Okay, it's individual, it's out on its own, it's detached. Whereas une maison jumelée is a semi-detached house. Jumeau and jumelle would be the French for twins. So it's a twinned house, semi-detached. Une maison à deux étages, a two-story house. Une ferme, a farm, farmhouse. Une HLM stands for une habitation à loyer modéré. So it's accommodation at moderate rent. So it's council housing or social housing or affordable housing. Okay? Une HLM. Une résidence secondaire or un gîte is a holiday home. A secondary residence, a second home is a holiday home. Une chaumière is a cottage. Okay? Bon. Ma maison se trouve, my house is located, is situated, is found. You know the verb trouver on its own is to find. So se trouver, to be found, to be located. En ville, in town, in the city. Au centre-ville, in the town center, in the city center. Dans la banlieue, en banlieue, in the suburbs. La banlieue, the suburbs. Dans un lotissement, in a housing estate. Think there's lots of houses in a housing estate. Un lotissement. À la campagne, in the countryside. So whenever you have a French word with a G followed by the N, the G is typically silent. Here we have it again. À la montagne, in the mountains. Dans un village, in a village. Dans une ferme, on a farm. Au bord de la mer, beside the sea. Bon. If you're describing your house, quelques adjectifs. Ma maison est confortable. My house is comfortable. Ma maison est spacieuse. My house is spacious. Now, the adjective for spacious in the masculine is spacieux, ending in EUX, but I had to change it to EUSE because maison is feminine. Ma maison est petite. My house is small. Again, house is feminine, so petit, petite. Ma maison est grande. Okay, adding an E onto grand to make it grande. My house is big. Bon. Moi, j'habite dans un pavillon à la campagne. So that's just showing you putting the house together with the location. Nous habitons dans un appartement à Paris. Ils habitent dans une maison jumelée en ville. Okay, the verb habiter, which you're well used to, a regular ER verb, so to live in. J'habite, tu habites, il habite, elle habite, nous habitons, vous habitez, ils habitent, elles habitent. Now, just to point your attention again to the other verb to live, vivre, okay, because it's irregular. Donc, je vis, tu vis, il, elle en vit. Nous vivons, vous vivez, ils vivent. It would be nice for you to use that if you had to, as opposed to habiter, just to bring up the quality of your work, make it higher level. Vivre, but stick with habiter if it's plus facile. Bon. L'extérieur de la maison. So the outside of the house vocab. L'extérieur de la maison. So this typically now could come up in a reading comprehension or more often actually in reading or in the listening. Le toit de la maison. Le toit is the roof. Le toit, the roof. Le volet is the shutter. Now we wouldn't typically have them in Irish homes. It's not really a cultural thing in Ireland. But in France, it would be part of their culture, part of their homes. The design of the houses, so the shutters and the window. I suppose why they would have them is, particularly in the south for the hot weather, you close the shutters during the daytime, they're slatted, they're vented. It allows the air in to circulate and air the room, but it shields the heat of the sun from coming in. So le volet, the shutter. Le jardin de devant is the front garden. Le jardin de derrière, the back garden. Le garage, the garage. La cheminée. So outside, la cheminée is the chimney. La porte is the door. Okay, la porte, the door. Think of a hotel porter. His job or her job is to open the door for you, let you into the hotel. So they're working at the door. So la porte, the door. La porte d'entrée is the front door. La fenêtre is the window. La barrière, the gate. Think the barrier from your house and the outside world. La boîte aux lettres, the letterbox. La véranda is the conservatory, okay? The conservatory. La terrasse is the patio. So some of you might have a patio outside the back of your home. So la terrasse. Now keep an open mind. If you ever read a comprehension and it's talking about a restaurant and outdoor dining, that outdoor dining outside the front of the restaurant, they call la terrasse. Bon? La façade de la maison. La façade is the outside, the front of the house, I should say. The front of the house. Okay. L'intérieur de la maison. So let's go inside the house. To les pièces. Les pièces de la maison. The rooms of the house. Now, there's a couple of different words for rooms. Like your bedroom would be la chambre. The rooms in a school or the rooms in a hospital. A waiting room would be la salle. La salle. Okay, but when you're talking about the rooms of a house, it's les pièces de la maison. Bon, le salon, the sitting room. Think a salon is lovely and relaxing. Think beauty salon, you go in there to get pampered. Typically, we go into our sitting room to just relax and chill out. So, le salon. Le séjour is the living room. But really, realistically, they're both almost identical to each other. Le salon, le séjour. Le bureau here means the office, obviously it can mean the desk. Le sous-sol is the basement. I suppose we typically wouldn't have them in Ireland, they're more of an American thing, aren't they? Le sous-sol, it literally stands for the underground. Sol in French means ground, so underground, the basement. L'escalier, the stairs. Think of an escalator, you're going up. Think if a problem is escalating, it's rising, it's going up. So l'escalier, the stairs. Le grenier is the attic. The attic. Make sure you know that word, that could come up now in listening work. So le grenier, the attic. Le vestibule in a house is the hallway. Okay, le vestibule. But in a school or in a hospital setting, it would be called le couloir. Le couloir would be the corridor. So le vestibule, the hall, le couloir, the corridor. L'ascenseur is the lift or the elevator. Think you're ascending, you're going up. Okay, so l'ascenseur, the elevator, the lift. Le balcon is the balcony. Le palier is the landing. Okay, so the landing, think of the upstairs area. Le plafond is the ceiling. Le plafond, the ceiling. Une pièce is a room. Remember, just refers to a room in a house. L'entrée would be the front entrance. Think the front hallway. La cuisine is the kitchen. La salle à manger is the dining room. Think the room to eat. La buanderie is the utility. La véranda, as we said earlier, was the conservatory. La salle de jeu is the games room or the playroom. La salle de bain, the bathroom. La chambre, the bedroom. La chambre à coucher. So literally the room to sleep. So the bedroom. La cave is the cellar. So we know that that's a typical feature of French homes where they, it's like the basement in America where they store the wine because it keeps it cool. Les toilettes, the toilets, okay? The toilet. En bas refers to downstairs. En bas, think bas is low, so think lower level. And en haut, upstairs. Anything haut is high. Au rez-de-chaussée. Now make sure you're familiar with that phrase. Au rez-de-chaussée is on the ground floor. And if you were in a hotel in France and you were in the lift and you wanted to click the button for the ground floor, it would probably be RDC written on the button. So au rez-de-chaussée, the ground floor. Okay, and just going back to that picture, le premier étage, the first floor, étage is floor or story. Deuxième étage is the second floor. Bon. Okay, so I'll go on to les meubles in a different video just to give you a chance.